Hello, this video is designed for people who are completely new to Ubuntu and who are more used to the Microsoft Windows operating system, and on first look they don't know what on earth's going on. Well, as you can see, Ubuntu is quite different from Windows in the way it's set out. The desktop's far less cluttered, there's just nothing there basically, everything's hidden away in different places. Incidentally, this is the default look of Ubuntu. It can be changed to a more aesthetically pleasing one if you don't like this setting. Basically, everything with Windows is down on the bottom left hand side, this area here, where you'd have the start menu if you've got XP, or the start orb if you're using Windows Vista or Windows 7. But with Ubuntu, everything's basically up at the top left hand side. So as you can see, applications, places and system. Under applications, your various subcategories here, which have your calculator, etc., and the terminal, which you may have to use now and again. The terminal is basically like the MSS board. And you've got a set of games, you've got graphics programs, you've got photo manager, an image editor, and a scanning program as well, all inbuilt. For the internet, the default browser is Firefox, which you can see the icon at the top there. You've also got a BitTorrent client as well, called Transmission. And you've got Evolution email, and you've got Empathy InstaMeshing client, which I've not used, so I don't really know much about that. But it's an all-in-one InstaMeshing program where you can use your MSN contacts and Yahoo contacts, etc., etc. Then the next section is Office, where you've got dictionary, presentation, spreadsheet, and word processor. That's with OpenOffice. And you've got underneath that sound and video. You've got a disk burner, and default you've got a music player and a movie player. I've added a few extras to make this recording. There are loads of different software you can have from the Ubuntu Software Center. Let's click on that now. And it gives you different subcategories here. And you can choose which ones you wish, really. There's all sorts there for virtually anything you want to do. And you just type in the search box here what you want. And then you'll have to put in your password. And then it'll install automatically. Now, this is the thing with Ubuntu, it's not just point and click and you install. You have to give your password every time you install a program. And there's two ways of installing programs, as I said, through the Ubuntu Software Center, or you can get hold of what are called deb files. But again, you have to put in your password each time. That gives you an extra layer of security. Now, if you notice in Windows, you've got My Documents, My Computer, etc. Well, to get hold of that, it's under Places, and the shortcuts are here. Let's zoom in. And the Home folder. There's another way of accessing it. So it's there, the same as Windows, but in a different way of organising things out. Under System, you got your preferences. That's the same as Control Panel in Windows, where you can change your sound preferences, screensaver, that sort of thing. Administration. Again, that's very similar to Control Panel, where you've got Synaptic Package Manager, which is very similar to the Software Manager, but it has extra software in there. So it's up to you which one you choose, really. The Update Manager, you can do it manually, but usually it's at the top where the time is. it'll be an automatically give you a message if you need to install any updates, and that's one thing you have to do, is install updates to secure the system. It's got a system monitor, tells you how much memory you're using, that sort of thing. It's all compact there for you. It's even got a help section here. On the right hand side, you've got the speaker icon, which you can mute or maximize. Then there's the network icon next to that. The envelope is related to the Empathy intermeshing system and also the Evolution email. I don't use those. Next is calendar and time. And the next is where you log out and restart the computer. On the bottom right hand side here is the, well, what would be the recycle bin. And next to that are two little squares there, so you can change your desktop. So for example, if one of your desktop was full of icons, just move on to the second one and then it would just be a complete blank desktop for you to work with. That's very, very productive, that. Moving over to the bottom left hand side, that is very similar to Windows, where you get hold of your desktop by clicking on that particular icon there. So as you can see, there are some similarities between Ubuntu and Windows. It's just the way it's been set out, it's a bit different. And that's basically it really. It's a short and sweet introduction to Ubuntu, what it's all about. If you look at my videos, you'll find an awful lot more information about how you can theme it, what programs you can install, how to configure it, etc, etc. As a general overview, this is just a very simplistic one really, and I hope you enjoy Ubuntu. Thanks for watching.